And you'll see, you know, beautiful styling on all our cars. The 8 cars we have to drive are in the front driveway here. This is kind of the 9th car. This happens to be an all-wheel drive, fully loaded with technology package car. So I can reference the other cars that are standing around you so you understand kind of where we're at. Again, it's wider, lower, and longer. It's a 0.29 CD vehicle. The wave-like hood we talked about earlier has this elegant wave-like form. It has two hood primary latches to keep this in exact form. You move up this way, let's talk a little bit about the front of the car. It has what we're calling this sword-like grille. Again, this is from the ancient art of Japanese swordsmanship is kind of the inspiration for this grille design. The lights are close tolerance fitted to the car to allow us to do all these seductive shapes around it. You see no square off edges at all. We're able to locate those lights in space and pull the bumper and the sheet metal around it to give you the most design opportunity you can for styling. We also have AFS headlights, which will turn left on a left turn, right on a right turn as you're turning about a 23 degree move to the right. I can even demonstrate that for you if you like. Again, dual primary latches to get an excellent fit of the hood. We have a single secondary latch. Everything is symmetrical. Dual intakes. Again, we talked about the ram air effect at 60 mile an hour. With this design, you get about 3 horsepower in addition to the 306 that it's rated at. We have dual exhaust. We have dual takedowns on both sides of the dual exhaust to get you the most pleasant exhaust sound. Full dual all the way to the back of the car. Again, 306 at 6,800 RPMs, 268 at 5,200. And again, variable valve intake and exhaust. We had it on intake in previous generations of this engine. Now it's on exhaust as well. Okay. We look at the interior of the vehicle. Again, to enter the vehicle, you never have to take your key out of your pocket. There's a push button on the door that will unlock the vehicle and allow you to enter the vehicle. There's also a push button start. It seems I'm entering the car without doing that. We call it a modern warmth interior. Everything you touch and feel is soft and high quality. We talked about the new lighting, which is white with violet accents. 7-inch touchscreen on the navigation system. Audio system.
In Los Angeles, there's like 50.
And I took a look at his license. 10-inch subwoofers in the doors, 3-inch mid-range, soft dome tweeter in each door set, center 3-inch speaker in the front, 6.5 door speakers in the rear, and subwoofer in the back is the Studio on Wheels concept. Comfortable seats. Again, the aluminum trim we talked about, the Japanese art of handmade paper, we call it washi. It's inspired with that kind of a design. This is really aluminum with that grafted on or etched on to this design. But again, it's a Japanese heritage item. Synchronized seats. I don't know if I can demonstrate it here for you with the door open, but essentially if you set your seat. To whatever you have selected as your presets. Again, put on the brake, touch the button, push the start. On the sport seat, this happens to be a non-sport, but you'll notice on the sport seat there's additional controls in the front to regulate the bottom cushion and in the rear torso. There's also an extendable front cushion on the sport seat. So basically a 12-way, very comfortable seat, a hand-stitched wheel on the Sport, as we talked about before, with premium leather. Also, the Sport has some other interior changes I can show you on the Sport. Bluetooth is an available option. This happens to have a technology package, which includes the navigation system, the premium audio system. It includes such devices as a rear-view monitor. So when you put the vehicle in reverse, you see the rear view out of the camera and shows distance up to 12 feet behind the vehicle. Nav traffic, whenever traffic or whatever navigation and XM are on the same vehicle in major metros. The 9.5 gigabyte hard drive is included in the center console area. The center CD will feed all the music into that. You can also play a 6 CD changer, which happens to be in the trunk in this configuration. And there's also a small plate here that allows for a compact flash memory device to be included. If you have MP3 songs recorded and you want to play them on this vehicle, that can be inserted correctly here. Also, updates to the vehicle will use this port to update the navigation system when it comes time to do that, or to update any of the software and electronics on the vehicle. So we're using this port for playback and for future service, okay? Heated seats, there's a snow switch for all all-wheel drive vehicles, which puts you into 50-50 front-rear torque mode. Again, this is a all-wheel drive vehicle, so it starts at 50 front and 50 rear, and then moves to zero front and 100% rear drive in normal driving situations. So it's really a rear drive vehicle unless the need to move torque to the front, and it'll move to the wheels that do have traction. Right? We talked about Bose 374 watts 10 speaker system. We talked about the different modes that this transmission can be operational in. If you're in drive, you're in the normal drive position. You move to the left, you'll see DS displayed on the instrument panel. You're now in sport mode. And then if you move it forward or backward, you'll be in individual manual mode. And each of those will be held in that gear until you release it up or down. On a sport AT car, you'll also have magnesium paddles that are right here at the steering column. This happens to be a non-sport all-wheel drive car. The wheels and tires you see, again, are 17-inch, 225, 55 VR17 tires. The Sport, which is right behind you, the silver car, is a Sport, dark gray car, with 18-inch wheels and tires. Those wheels and tires are available as an option on non-all-wheel drive, non-sport cars. We talked about the rear active steer car. That silver car in the front of the stack is our prototype with four-wheel active steer. So that's the only vehicle in this set with four-wheel active steer. It happens to be an automatic. If you move to the back of the car, a couple of things I can point out. Again, LED taillights in two circular patterns is kind of a trademark for the G35 since 2005. We also have that on the M. We have integrated backup lamp. We also have a release. Again, if your key is in your pocket, you can release and open your trunk without having to use a key. And it's a big spacious trunk. The CD6 with the navigation system is housed back here. And again, all new exterior design, large exhaust, and exhaust note is also very emblematic. I had to share with you. Where's the camera? Where is the camera? That was here. Lots of interior roominess. Cup holders in the center and in the doors. There's rear seat cup holders in the center. It's made to make everyone comfortable. This is a car that didn't forget the rear seat passengers. Interior roominess is larger than the previous car without adding a lot of weight and a lot of size. So dimensions of